Here in Milwaukee, MLB The Show has action out of the NL Central. It's the St. Louis Cardinals and the Milwaukee Brewers. First pitch coming your way next. Just about to get started. Pitching in our game today, Brandon Woodruff.
Well, he's not a rookie, but still very young in this game, learning his craft. I think the key is getting consistent reps and the opportunity to develop his stuff. Looking forward to watching him pitch in this one.
So just about set now. Now it's the right fielder, Dylan Carlson. The pitch. High fly ball out to center field. Kane should have this one. Puts the squeeze on it. One up, one down. Here's Paul Goldschmidt. First pitch just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
Next offering is in for a strike.
I mean, that's perfect location, right on the black. I mean, over and over again, this guy demonstrates the ability to hit those spots. They're so tough to do anything with as a hitter.
Kane makes the catch, and there's two down. And now Tyler O'Neill. This guy has turned into a beast. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And a big swing and a miss.
Well, the hitter looked pretty comfortable on that swing. Pitchers don't like to see that. We'll see how he changes it up on this next pitch.
On the ground, Adames handles, whips it to first on the run, and O'Neill is retired. And that is that. 1-2-3 go to Cardinals. It's the Cardinals nothing, and the Brewers coming to bat. Bottom of the first, and on the mound today, a guy who will give them innings, Adam Wainwright.
He's racked up over 2,000 strikeouts in his career. He's such a competitor out in the mound. So fun to watch him work. I'm excited for this one.
Bottom of the first, Colton Wong up to hit.
I mean, these guys know they have to get going out of the gates, but you're not going to hear a skipper. You're not going to hear people really say that.
0-1.
Because this game's hard enough, and, you know, you try to minimize the pressure that you put on yourself or that you take in from outside. So, you know, sticking to the plan, the process, every day, coming in, doing your work, making the adjustments you need to make, and just focusing on the task at hand that day.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Got him. And there's one down. Willie Adames stands in. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Next pitch is outside. One down, base is empty. Ripped to third. Toss to Pools, and here this afternoon, two quickly away in the bottom of the first. Here's Yelich at the dish. And first offering is fouled off. comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
Well, we can see him muscle up a little bit. He's trying to hit the ball a mile. Got to make sure that he stays within himself so that those mechanics can allow him to hit the ball a long way.
That's down. One hops off the wall. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
A little more backspin on that instead of the top spin. And he's jogging around the bases rather than pulling up at second.
Here's Andrew McCutchen to hit. First offering misses the mark.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
And a swing and a miss.
Well, he's realizing out there on the mound that he's got to settle in pretty quickly or else he's going to get hit hard in this first inning.
Here's a 1-2.
That was the emergency hack right there.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Brewers strand one. We played an inning. No score. All set for the start of the inning. Here's Nolan Arenado. Woodruff back to work. This to third, and he grabs it foul. The 0-1. Swing and a miss. 0-2 now. Carl Dixon working the plate in this one.
You know, we often hear and talk about umpires being a pitcher's umpire, but Boog Dixon may be a little bit more hitter-friendly than most. He's kind of tight on the corners, so we'll see if that comes into play at all in this one.
McCutchen on the move. And there's one away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And a foul ball. The 0-1. And a foul ball. That one lifted to left. McCutchen moving under it. He's got it. Two down.
Fell off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Two outs, bases empty. Now up for St. Louis, Paul DeJong. And first offering is fouled off.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
No score here in the second. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. Way outside. And that is ball one. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And a pitch. They say it went. Narvaez with the throw to first. And that is the third out of the inning. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here in Milwaukee, we head to the bottom of the second. Up now for Milwaukee, Rowdy Tellez. Bounce to the right side. Edmund picks it up in plenty of time to first. Leadoff man retired here in the second. now it's Hunter Renfro. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Bader under it. Makes the grab for the second out. Omar Narvaez at the plate. Swings through that one. 0-1.
Looks like he went up there guessing on the first pitch and was going to sell out to it. Didn't make any contact, though.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
The hitter early and off balance on that swing. If I'm the pitcher, I'm taking a little bit more off. See if you can get him to chase something in the dirt.
That's a hit.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. 110 miles per hour, and man, that exit velocity, not every hitter's capable of getting that kind of jump off the bat, no matter how hard they swing.
Now it's Lorenzo Cain. Swing and a ball hammered left field. Pretty well struck. Grabs it right up against the wall. Milwaukee leaves one. We'll move to the third with no score. Welcome back. And now, Harrison Bader. Here comes a pitch. Swings through that one out in front that time. Swings here and blasts one left field. That's going back. Back some more. Up against the wall and makes the catch. And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Throw over to Tellez, and Molina is retired. You gotta be kidding me. Did you see that throw?
Not really, Boog. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. I mean, you don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
The pitch. High in the air, out to right. Renfro on the move to the alley. And that is that. Redbirds down quietly, and we are still scoreless. Back here at the ballpark, set for the bottom of the third. Up now for Milwaukee, Jace Peterson. And a foul ball. Oh, one down. Right side, hard hit. Pujols to first. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Colt Luong will hit next. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
The wind and the pitch. On the ground, right side, Edmund gloves it, sends it to first. That takes care of Wong. Next for Milwaukee, Willy Adames. Nope. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. Foul ball. Ground ball left side, and that's just foul. Two outs. way inside, gets out of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next one misses. Full count now.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Gone in order are the Brewers. And we're still knotted at zero. Start of the fourth. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Dylan Carlson. The why to kick the pitch. Into center. Kane gets under it. Makes the catch. One away. Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. Well struck left field. That's back. And that ball is gone. Paul Goldschmidt goes deep. His first homer of the year. It's 1-0.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
One out, base is empty. Now here is Tyler O'Neill. Grounded out his first time. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Man, that was pretty gross right there.
Stays alive. Swing and a broken bat flare. On the run, throw to first. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Here's Nolan Arenado. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. Rolled over to third. Throws to first. That ends the frame. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Digging in, Christian Yelich. On the ground at first. Pujols takes it himself. One up, one down.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Here's a drive by McCutchen. Out to left. Well struck. And gone. Andrew McCutchen, the last one out. And this game is tied. It's 1-1. He sent the first pitch over the wall.
Must have dinner reservations because he wasn't wasting any time at the plate in that at bat. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
So one out, nobody on. At the plate, Rowdy Tellez grounded out his first time. And that one wrapped foul. Righty to the plate. That one fouled off. Up the middle. To first. Two gone now. Two outs. Base is empty. And the batter now, Hunter Renfro. And the first pitch misses for ball one. That one drilled left field. That's got a chance. Hauls it in on the warning track. Solo homer brings the Brewers even. All even at one apiece. Back here at American Family Field. Top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Albert Pujols. Next pitch is popped up. Peterson in position. Makes the grab. And there's one down. Now it's Paul DeJong up to the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
These hitters are going to have to find a way to be a little more patient, see more pitches per at bat. Otherwise, that bullpen's not going to have to work over there, and it's going to be advantage pitching all game long.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Line to left, and it drops in, but a good job to keep it in front.
Nice line drive to the pull side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now Bader up to the plate. And that one is lifted in the air. Kane on the move to his right. And makes the grab. And there are two down. Now Molina at the plate. Out to short, sneaks through, base hit. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Tommy Edman at the plate. Up the middle, Adames picks it up, third out.
He's out.
So the Cards strand a couple, score remains tied 1-1. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the Brewers catcher now, Omar Narvaez.
Here we go.
Fouled off to the right. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss.
This game has been so tight, feels like the next team to score will win it.
Foul ball, he stays alive. The 0-2. Fought off foul. Stays alive. Next offering is in the dirt. Got him swinging. And that's the first out. Lorenzo Cain up now for the Brewers. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game, but ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Check on the runner. Diving back in is Kane. Kane leads off first with one away. Squirts away a little bit. Save! That one ran inside, almost got him.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
And he deals. In the dirt. The throw is late, and the defense comes away with nothing. Runner on at third, one gone.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next offering misses, and the count's full. Kicks and deals. Right side, Pujols collects, tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Now two away as they get a run across. Colton Wong up now for the Brewers. Foul ball there. Ground ball right side. Edmund over to pick it up. The throw to first. That takes care of Wong. Inning over. We're through five. It's the Brewers 2 and the Cardinals 1. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. This is Dylan Carlson. Swing and a miss, and that is strike one.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
A lot of times you'll see a pitcher maybe double up on a pitch. This guy will throw it three times, four times in a row because hitters just can't lay off of it.
Tosses to first, and that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth. So now here's the Cardinals' designated hitter, Paul Goldschmidt. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Several 0-2 counts in this one. This guy out there has just been attacking the hitters. Really good job so far.
Next offering is fouled back. The pitch. And fouled off. The wind of the pitch. Bounce to the left side. Sneaks through, base hit.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
Here's Tyler O'Neill. In there for strike one. One run game, one out, one on. Next offering is fouled back.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but he's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
Stays alive. The next pitch misses, and it's 1-2.
I got the count, 1-2.
Pulls that one foul. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up.
Quite the matchup we're seeing here. Six foul balls in this at-bat alone. Really making them work out there.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult to get the barrel on it.
Arenado swings through one there. And that one hammered. That's back. Hauls it in on the warning track. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Brewers 2 and the Cardinals 1. Bottom of the sixth. Up now for Milwaukee, Willy Adames. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch misses. One ball, one strike. Next offering is fouled back. Kicks and fires. The punch out there, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. And now it's Christian Yelich, 1-2.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
There's a swing and a drive. Hits the fence. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
He has had such a good day today. I don't think he's going to want to leave when it's over.
Couple of doubles today for the DH. McCutchen in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Bullpen action for the Cardinals. TJ McFarland appears to be getting loose. Whitgren warming up as well. The 1-0. Ripped to short. Tosses to first. That's it out. And here's the first baseman, Rowdy Tellez. Good power, not great in the OBP department. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Yelich on its second with two down. There's a foul ball.
Yeah, with two strikes here, you really want to miss outside the zone with that breaking ball.
Line drive, and that's a base hitter to right. And they hold the runner at third base as they decide not to risk the send with two away. So, Singy, let's dive into the numbers courtesy of StatCast. Do you even feel contact being made when you hit a ball that hard?
No, I don't think so, Boog. I mean, that's just the best feeling in the world as a hitter. You square it up perfectly, and it's like you didn't even swing the bat. And there are times the ball feels heavy off your bat. You know it, but this is not one of those cases. He sent this one flying 114 miles per hour, so that's flexing your muscles a little bit.
Yeah, the right-hander deals. A little out front there as he swings through it.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
0-2 now. And that one goes straight to the backstop. Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. Hunter Renfroe hits one out, his first homer of the year, and they add to their lead. It's 5-1.
Well, he put a really nice swing on that one, and everything was on time, took a direct path to the ball, excellent extension, and just drove it out of here. Nothing better than when the ball jumps off your bat like that.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Adam Wainwright will depart, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. The new pitcher in the game, Ryan Helsley. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Fires over to first. That ends the inning. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. It's now 5-1. Top of inning number 7, and now it's Albert Pujols' turn to hit. Woodruff back to work. And there's a ball. In the air, left field. McCutchen moving in on this one. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And a quick out number 1.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay closed.
Now it's Paul DeJong up to the plate. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Peterson moving under this one. Brings it in, and there's two away. And now Bader up to the plate. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And that one pulled foul.
Yeah, we go beyond just the fielding percentage and what it looks like, but the ability to have a range and close holes that are normally there against an average defender. But this guy is special, and you can see it in his first step quickness.
Next pitch off the play, and it's 2-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Drops into the glove, and that'll do it. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. They're down 5-1. Set for the last half of the 7th. Now it's Lorenzo Cain. The wind of the pitch. Ball 1, no strikes. Next pitch is outside. Next one misses, and that's ball three. Swing and a ball lifted left field. O'Neill drifts towards it, makes the catch, and there's one gone. Now it's Jace Peterson. First offering, and it just misses. Next offering is in for a strike. On the ground, right side. Edmund slings to first. Two up, two down. Colton Wong up to hit. And he hits a ground ball right side. Toss to Pools, and that's the third out. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. They lead this one, though, 5-1. And welcome back. And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina. And the right-hander back to work. And there's the strike.
Usually when a pitcher's had a dominant outing, he has filled up the strike zone and he's gotten ahead in the count with first pitch strikes. Well, that's exactly what this guy has done in this one. Over 70% first pitch strikes.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
That one ripped. Puts it away for the out. Tommy Edman at the plate. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Bounce to the right. Takes it himself. It. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth. This is Dylan Carlson. In the air, out towards left center. Nice grab, McCutcheon. Able to make that play. And that is that. And down in order go the Cardinals. They're down here 5-1. Out of the bottom of the eighth, Willy Adames stands in. The pitch.
Nope.
Started to swing, held up.
Ball one, no strike.
And now it's even up.
One ball, one strike.
Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. Just misses the mark outside the zone.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Now a rocket to right center. Way back there, and forget it. It's out of here. Christian Yelich leaves the yard. His first homer of the year, and they add a run. It's 6-1.
a guy's got a real hard fastball, you can't overswing. All you've got to do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
Base is empty, one away, and now it's Andrew McCutchen. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Two as he waves at that one. Action in the pen down there. TJ McFarland up and loosening in the pen. Whitgren getting cranked up as well. Lifted in the air right center field. Bader has a beat on it. Puts it away for the out. Here's Rowdy Tellez. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Count 1-0.
Up the middle. DeYoung handles the chance. On to first. That's the third out. Inning over. But the Brewers add one with a solo shot. Last chance coming up here for the Cards. Welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Now it's the DH, Paul Goldschmidt. There's a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Wong picks it up, gets it to first, and they get Goldschmidt for the out. Here's Tyler O'Neill. Pretty amazing athlete this guy is. Power and speed, quite a threat. I mean, you're talking about someone that could steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone? That one hammered, but pulled foul. And the pitch. They say it went. Out to short. Whips it across. And they're down to their last out.
Fastball grooved right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air. Maybe drive it into the gap.
Here's Nolan Arenado. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. Swings through that one. 0-1.
This guy plays third base like he's a shortstop, and he welcomes the difficult play, can throw from so many different angles, and makes really tough plays look very easy.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. And that'll do it. As they complete the strikeout to end it.
It seemed like from the first pitch of this ball game, this guy was going to get it done. A quality start, who knew he'd throw a complete game and get the victory. But an excellent job of continuing to just throw what the catcher put down. He navigated through this ball game, a jam here, a jam there, but ultimately it was an outstanding outing.
6-1 is your final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.